All right, what's going on? Got forearms today. Forearm days are probably the most simple days. I might add in some abs today too. Yeah, I think I'm gonna make this a forearm and ab day. I haven't done abs in some months, so we're gonna do those today. So let's get today started. All right, we're gonna start off with something simple. We're gonna do some just kind of wrist drops for the forearms. So I'm gonna grab some dumbbells. I got some 30s, so I'm just gonna kind of sit on the bench, kind of have the dumbbells sitting on my quads and kind of just lift up like this. Yep. Pretty simple. Bro, from when I was doing legs in the last video, I did the hip adductors and the, bro, my groin is cooked from that workout, and I knew it was gonna happen. Just get some more of these in. It's pretty simple. You're gonna have your arms laying on your digs, and just kind of curl up. Yeah. Yeah. These strengthen your wrist as well. Like, not only does it hit forearm, but I would say it strengthens your wrist as well. All right, so we're already here. So we're gonna do something a little bit different today. So this workout kind of hits the bicep, but it's cool. You know, we hitting those tomorrow. So I'm just gonna show you guys. So I got some lighter weight because forearms. So I'm just gonna kind of hold them like this. One, two. Two, three, four, five, six, eight. Yeah, so the isometric hold when you're holding that in that angle, begin to burn on the forearms. So, you know what I mean? Second set, let's go. I like that movement. That's new to me, so feels pretty good. All right, let's get this last set in. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So even though I'm feeling those in the bicep, I'm feeling them primarily in the forearms. You can add that to your bicep day though. That feels really good. So let's move on to the next. All right, so next workout. I'm gonna grab some dumbbells like these and kind of just bring it in towards you. just kind of let it fall and bring it up with your wrist. Yep. Those feel good. Those are pretty simple. I've always done those. So you want some big forearms, do those. Like you bring it in. It gets that inside part. Yeah. So I'm gonna do two more sets of that and I don't know, we'll figure something out. All right, let's get it. I like those. Let's get this last set in. Here at the cables, I'm gonna be doing a variation of a face pull, but it's gonna be forearm dominant, obviously, because we're doing forearms. So I'm gonna grab an attachment like this, kind of just grab it. That's a little light. Yeah, 90. Kind of pull it to my face like this. Yep. It's a pretty simple movement. It's kind of easy. I would up the weight on here, which is what I'm gonna do. Let me go 110. I'll put you guys. Movement is pretty easy, I'm not gonna lie. Feels good too. So we're doing that. It's getting the bigger part of the forearm. Oh. Excuse me. I'm gonna up it a lot more action. Let's get it in. We're gonna stay here. I'm gonna use the same attachment. The good thing about this attachment is it kind of rotates a little bit, so it's gonna help us with what we're about to do next. So I'm gonna kind of grab it like this and kind of let my wrist do the work. If you have like a handlebar attachment like this, works really well with getting that forearm pump. So I'm gonna go up and wait. And let's go. Yeah. Woo. That feels really good, man. I feel like this workout right here probably gets your forearms the most pumped out of everything. Let's get this last set in. We're gonna stay here. We're gonna move to the single arm attachment. I figured that we just do all of the downward movements and then move on to the bottom one. So just gonna get this in. So you notice this attachment has like a rolling thing, like that helps a lot when you're doing the little workouts because you're doing a lot of wrist work. So if you got that, lose that. Let's get this in, my boy. These burn, bro. They feel really good, man. Honestly, bro, after being in the gym for so long, you grow to love it, bro. I love being in here. I just love being around people that are like working towards the same goal as me. Like, it motivates me. It just feels good to see, you know what I mean? So, got one more set of this, and then we'll go for the upward movements. All right, we're getting a lot of cable work in today. Nothing wrong with that. So what I'm about to do right here, it's basically replacing the easy bar curl like that. So we're just gonna do it on the cables right here. So I'm gonna grab the attachment. Kind of just. Yeah. To be honest, man, I think I like that a little bit better than doing the easy bar curls with that. I'm really a big fan of the cables, like, big fan. So, I'm gonna go up two, do 110 right here. Yeah, for forearms, bro, just be prepared for a lot of wrist work. There's a lot of wrist work involved when you're doing forearms. Get this last set in, and I think we got two more. Actually, no, we got a couple more after this, so let's go. All right, we're gonna do these 90 degree, pretty much isolated or isometric forearm curls. Not really curls, but I've done these in my previous videos. Show you guys what they look like. just gonna kind of grab the bar like this, 90 degree, wrist fall, wrist fall. Wrist fall. Yes. Just feel good, man. Those are, I wanna say, probably my second favorite forearm workout. Feel good, so let's get this in. Yep. Hop. 90 degree. Ball. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep. Yep. Let's feel real good. So I'm gonna stay at the same weight, and then after this, we'll do something else. I don't know. Figure it out. 9 degree. 4. I'm sitting here trying to figure out what to do next, and I think I just invented something again. So I got an attachment like this, so I think I'm gonna just kind of do like that. Bro. I don't know what I'm gonna call that, bro. I haven't seen anybody do that though. I think I just created something again. So when you're doing that, I'm feeling it like right here. That feels good, man. I'm gonna do that for 3 sets. And then, honestly, after this, I think I'm just gonna do abs. That feels really good, bro. I don't know what I gotta call that. I'll figure out something. Yeah, I like that, bro. That feels really, really good, bro. Man, that's honestly the perfect, I want to say superset. I call it a burnout. Do that right after the 90-degree forearm curls. I'm feeling it like all right here, bro. This is amazing. Let's get it out one more time. All right, I couldn't tell you the last time I had some abs, but I'm gonna do them today, like I said. So honestly, this is kind of the easy way to go out with the abs. So if you have a machine like this, use this. So I like to grab a plate. Let me show you guys. I like to do that with a plate and do the same thing without a plate. So, show you guys.
Yeah.
Bro, that was one set, by the way. I don't do abs. Man, bro. It's like a super neglected muscle group for me. Just because, like, I don't know, you don't gotta do too much with them. I mean, you do, but like, I burn so many calories by working out, like, my abs are gonna show. So I don't really have to do these, but I mean, that's just one set, so we got three more, or two more. Give myself a break, though.
Oh, okay.
So you see the little set that I just did, man. That was super tough, but
it's worth it. Let's go.
When you get to those side little twists, that's when it gets tough. But come on. Dog, it's been so long since I've done them, bro. I ain't gonna lie to you. Come on.
No, I can't do it.
Honestly, the first little set, that was as best as I could do. As best as I could do. The last one on here, I'm gonna try my best, bro, but don't hold me to it.
Like I said, man, I've been bulking. I haven't done abs since like
March, bro. Like, no joke.
Let's try it.
No, I can't do the side ones.
I can't do the side ones. No.
So, honestly, these ab workouts that I'm doing they're kind of like the give me over workouts. Like, it's not a real good ab workout. Like, it can be, but if you really want to get some working with abs, you got to go like do a circuit. Like, you got to go do a circuit like of like sit ups, crunches, like planks. So you got to do all of that in one. But honestly, I'm not ready for that yet, so I'm just doing these to get back into the groove of things. So right here, I got a rope. I'm gonna do some pull downs and kind of crunch my abs. I don't really know what to call these. My friends call them AOs. I don't know why. But so when I do this, I'm gonna grab this rope, get a weight that I can do, and I'm gonna keep my core flexed the entire time when I'm doing it. So I'm kind of flex my core. It's flexed right now. So I'm just gonna pull it down and just you keep your core flexed right there. Kills. So I'll do these for two more sets. I'll even do the full stack today. Why not? Go 180 right here. So keep your abs flex, core flex. Grab the rope.
I'm not.
These are sissy ab workouts, but bro, they still work. They don't work as good as, like I said, as crunches and the sit-ups and the, all those other things. But they still get, you, you know what I mean?
All right. Flex up.
All right, that wraps up today's video. Forearms, man, it's pretty simple. As you can see, these forearms are looking crazy. Yeah, I mean, I guess I could show the abs too. Like, I gotta get a thumbnail. I don't know. I don't know if this is thumbnail worthy, but yeah, pretty much wraps up today's video. Forearms is pretty simple. Abs, I can't give you any promises that I'll restart doing those because I don't do them like at all. They hurt. I'm not gonna lie. Like, legs and abs are two of the most dreadful muscle groups to work. But man, there was one time I was so locked in doing abs though. Like, I had a crazy six pack. Like, I have one now. Like, the thing with abs, like, they're already under, like, they're under your, like, fat. So, like, you burn fat, you're going to see them a lot more. But the muscle's already somewhat developed, but it's just under the layer of fat or skin that you have over it. So once I start burning fat, like, once I start burning fat and I, like, I lose, like, these side handles and everything like that, these will be, like, a lot more visible. And honestly, I'm kind of ready to start cutting. But I got, like, I think I'm going to bulk until, like, March or something. I don't know. Because I might go back to playing football next year. So I don't know how my diet's going to look. I don't know what everything will look like. So, yeah, I think tomorrow we have biceps and triceps. One of my favorite days. So, yeah, if you enjoyed this video, drop a like. If you, you know, got some value out of it, drop a like, drop a sub. I'm trying to hit at least 100 subs by the end of the year. I think I could do that, man. I'm going to be posting every single day for an entire year. I started in November. I think I started November 8th. So I think this might be the 23rd or 22nd video that I've recorded. Yeah. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, drop a like. Peace.